going to take you to one of our most favorite places in the world, Tuscany. And the video that you're about to see is going to give you a rough overview of how to spend an authentic day in the countryside in Tuscany. Because it is such a big and beautiful place with so many different towns, we've zeroed in on one little part of Tuscany that we love. And the itinerary today will give you a seamless way to explore all the different sites and experience all that Tuscany has to offer, while being a little cultured.
I'm searching for answers, 'cause all I know is I'm losing hope. I'm bathing in sunshine, lost in space, waiting for your sign to set me straight. Where do I go from here? When will this world see me? I'm bathing in sunshine, lost in space, waiting for your sign to set me straight.
Mallorca, where we stayed, was in this little beautiful town called San Puerco de Vieca, and it was an old Etruscan town that they revitalized, and we stayed at this beautiful old captain's house that was also refurbished with all the modern amenities that you can think of. So when we started the morning, we had a little breakfast at the hotel, and then we just walked through the streets. And the streets there, they have the beautiful churches, they have little cafes, and amazing little vintage shops that you can pop in and out of. I actually bought a beautiful new piece of art for our dining room, which I'm really excited about. But it's such a beautiful, quiet town where about, I think, 3,000 people still live, and a great way to start your morning.
Your light is my soul. I'm searching for answers. All I know is I'm losing hope in the sunshine.
And our second recommendation of things to see in Tuscany is Val d'Orca. Now, Val d'Orca spans an entire region of area, but there's one very quintessential site that you're going to want to check out, which is this incredible roadway that zigzags back and forth with these cypress trees that line the road.
It's like the picture that everyone sees in Tuscany. When you think of Tuscany, it is like the photo spots, all you grammars out there. Like, stop at this spot.
Definitely good for the gram. Olive Grove, a part of the larger La Foce estate. And on that particular olive grove, a woman by the name of Iris had saved it back when the valley was super, super poor. And now the olive grove today produces probably one of the most famed olive oils in all of Tuscany. And they were highlighted in the New York Times and other places, won tons of awards. They usually produce about 6 varietals. This year was only about 3, just because of the seasonality. But there, they have an amazing spread for you to taste things. They walk you through the actual process of the olive oil. They'll take you to the machines. They'll take you to the groves. And you really just get to if you've ever tasted olive oil, they take you through how to do that with your nostrils, with tasting in the back of your throat. I mean, it's such a really cool experience, whereas I know the wineries are amazing in Tuscany, and there's so many to choose from, but beyond wineries, because you'll definitely do that, I'm sure, you have to stop at an olive oil tasting. And this is the place to do that.
Nation, we recommend heading to the capital of Val d'Huerca called Pienza. This has an incredible view of the rolling hills, and it's this old Etruscan town that was built by Pope Pius II. We went there for lunch, and you can just spend hours there walking around with this gorgeous clock tower and just medieval looking city. I might just die bones. Get to that orange. I might just die bones. Get to that orange. I might just die. And for our fifth recommendation, we recommend heading to Bosco di Ciprese.
Ciprese.
This is this like quintessential pocket within Tuscany of all of these Etruscan trees. There's about, I don't know, 50 to 75 of them that are just like shaped in a square that are up on a hilltop mountain. And it just has an incredible sunset view. So we recommend heading here towards the end of the day to be able to catch the amazing shots of the sunset setting over the hills with this cool little like tucked away, very unique picturesque view of the Tuscan trees, cypress trees.
It is really cool. It's these trees that all kind of bundle together and look like a painting. It's something out of, I don't know, some dreamy Monet painting. And the sun just falls perfectly over the hills, and as the light drapes, all the colors change. And so if you stay there for about 20 minutes as the sun is going down, the pictures that you'll catch are amazing. The view and the experience itself is just amazing. And the way that the hills kind of roll around the mountains, there's not a bad view. So many people do stop off to the side to try and get a picture, but it's never too crowded. And if you have a drone, it's epic shots. And kiss me there, cause I'm a little cold, but I warm up with you. Heart up my chest when you put it there. Yeah, I'm a little cold, but I've warmed up with you. You won't be disappointed. We'll have another video on some other regions of Tuscany because obviously there is so much to see. If you like this video, please thumbs up, please share it with some friends. Dan's going to provide some of the logistics, your need to knows to have a seamless day of travel in the comments below. And we will see you next time on Tough Travel. Ciao. If you were wondering where we are right now, and all the birds that were chirping in the background, we are at our lovely hotel in Rome. This is the best value hotel I think we've ever been at.
Definitely a good value.
It looks like Restoration Hardware inside, and you have your own little spa and steam room. And this part of the rooftop, which the birds aren't out yet, but they were, and so if you hear them in the background, it's just our friends. Moments like these are golden. Never felt so open. Even if I'm dreaming, I'm dreaming with you. So breathe my air and kiss me there. Cause I'm a little cold, but I warm up to you. Heart up my chest when you put it there. Yeah, I'm a little cold, but I warm up.